Hi, welcome to webinar series on IoT. My name is Surinder Kumar and I'm working as a subject matter expert with FICE Education. Today's webinar is on serial communication protocol, and one of the type of serial communication protocol is called SPI, that is serial peripheral interface. And then we'll talk about the SD card interfacing and data logging on the SD card. So before discussing today's webinar, let's have a recap of previous webinar. Previous webinar was on serial communication protocol. One of the type of the protocol is UART, that is also called Universal Asynchronous Receiver and Transmitter. So in UART, basically we discuss about basics of serial communication. What is basically serial communication, how it works, the difference between serial communication and parallel communication. What is the difference between serial and parallel, how serial communication takes place and how parallel communication takes place, how we transmit the data in both the communication protocols. Then we talked about the examples of the serial communication. We took some examples of the serial communication. Then we focused on the UART protocol, Universal Asynchronous Receiver and Transmitter protocol. Then we talked about the UART interfaces supported by the Intel Galileo. How many UARTs are available on Galileo Gen 2 board? How we can access those UARTs? Then we talked about the UART based module supported by Intel Galileo. So what all are the modules that are available in the market that are supported by the Intel Galileo Gen 2 board? So we talked about them also. So in today's webinar, we are going to discuss about the SPI, that is serial peripheral interface, that is the type of serial communication protocol. So we'll talk about the introduction. What is basically SPI? Then we'll talk about the data transfer using SPI, how we can transfer the data, how data transfer takes place in SPI. Then we will talk about the communication configuration of SPI. So basically SPI is a master to slave communication. Then we will talk about SPI communication timing diagram. So how the data is being transferred from master to slave and slave to master with the help of a clock. So then we will talk about serial communication protocol and Intel Galileo Gen 2 board. So basically here we will talk about the SPI interface available on the Intel Galileo Gen 2 board. Then we'll talk about the SD card data logging. What is the use of SD card? Why we need to have SD card on Galileo? How we can store the data on SD card? How we can access the data from the SD card? And what is the use of storing the data on the SD card? So this is what we will discuss in today's webinar. So serial communication protocol, SPI. So SPI is stands as Serial Peripheral Interface, also called SPI. It is a synchronous serial data protocol used by microcontrollers processors for communicating with one or more peripheral devices quickly over short distance. So basically SPI is being used by microcontroller and processors to communicate with the onboard or short distances with the peripherals and sensors. So with an SPI connection, there is always one master device, usually a microcontroller or processor, which controls the peripheral devices. So basically, serial peripheral interface is master to slave communication, where one is the master, another one is the slave. And it takes four lines. One is the SCLK, that is called serial clock. Second is MOSI, that is called master out, serial in. Third one is MISO, master in, slave out. Then SS. So basically MOSI is master out, slave in. MISO is master in, slave out. And SS is called slave select, sometimes also chip select. So I told you, typically there are three lines common to all the devices. One is the MISO, that master in, slave out. Second is MOSI, master out, slave in. And third one is SCK or SCL, serial clock. So the MISO is the slave line for sending data to the master. MOSI is the master line for sending data to the peripherals, as its name suggests, master in, slave out. So slave will send the data and master will take the data. MOSI means master out, slave in. Master will send the data and slave will receive the data. So one line specific for every device, that is the slave select. The pin on each device that the master can use to enable and disable specific devices, that is called slave select. So master select or communicate with the slave with the help of slave select line. So first master generate a signal using slave select line and it selects the slave to whom master wants to communicate with. So this is how communication between master and slave takes place. So if we talk about first MSP, that is most significant bit is being transferred from transmitter to the receiver. So serial peripheral interface, there can be multiple slaves and master has to be only one. So SPI supports only one master and multiple the slaves. So the master generally can be a controller or processor. Slaves can be some, for example, other devices, peripherals, memories like that, and sensors. So basically the master and slave can communicate in two ways. One way is that each slave will need a separate select line to talk to a particular slave. We will make that slave select line low and keep the rest of them high. So generally the slave select line is kept high, and to whomsoever slave or peripheral master want to communicate, the master will make that slave select line low. So this type of communication is called active low. So where the master generates a low pulse to communicate or to select the slave. So this is multiple slaves and single master. So we don't want two slaves activated at the same time, or they may both try to talk one on the same meso line, resulting in a grabbed data. The second way is that where we use a single select line, because if you use the multiple select lines, slave select line, so there can be huge number of lines. And in that case, each slave will have the single meso and mosi. So second way is that where we use only single slave select for selecting the slaves. So some parts prefer to be daisy chained together with the meso, that is master in, slave out, output of the one going to the mosi, master out, slave in, input of the next. In this case, a single select line goes to all the slaves. Once all the data is sent, the slave select line is raised, which causes all the chips to be activated simultaneously. This is often used for the daisy chain shift registers and address LED drivers. So this type of communication generally we use when we don't want to get the data from the slave. We only want to write the data on the slave. So that is where we use only the single select line. For example, if we want to glow the LED, we want to write something on the peripheral. So in that case, we don't have to receive the data back. So what we'll do, we'll use this type of structure to communicate with the multiple slaves. Now, SPI, serial peripheral interface, communication timing diagram. So basically, SPI is a synchronous communication protocol or synchronous serial communication protocol where master and slave or transmitter and receivers are synchronized over a single clock pulse. So basically, this clock pulse is being generated by the master only. Slave cannot generate this clock pulse. So master generates a clock pulse, and these master and slave can be synchronized on falling edge or rising edge of the pulse. So what happens when data is sent from master to slave? It's sent on a data line called the MOSI, or master out, slave in. If the slave needs to send or responds back to the master will continue to generate a pre-arranged number of clock cycles, and the slave will put the data onto a third data line called MISO, or master in, slave out. So basically, whenever, for example, they are synchronized to the falling edge, so when clock is being generated by the master to the slave, only master can generate the clock. So whenever this falling edge comes for the clock, what will happen? Immediately the slave will check the data line, that is MOSI, and will start encoding the bits. So this is how it is doing. When falling edge of the clock is there, over here, falling edge is there, the slave will go to the data line, that is MOSI, and will start encoding the data. So here we have 1, 1, again from the falling edge, 0, 0, and so on, so forth. So after some time, basically it is being understood by the master itself. For example, if we are talking about API digital read, we are sending a data or analog read. We are sending this data to read the data. Obviously, what will return? It will return with the some data. So master will continue to generate. That is why the prearranged term is used over here. So master will continue to generate the clock pulse, and again the slave will keep on sending the data to the master. So that is how this communication takes place over a single clock pulse, and that is how master and slave are perfectly synchronized to transfer the data. Some of the cases we can use the full duplex also, where simultaneously we can send the data and receive the data also. For example, while we are retrieving the data from one pin, on the same time we can try to read the data from another pin also. So serial peripheral interface on Intel Galileo Gen 2 board. So ICSP, one 6-pin header is there, that is called inter-circuit serial programming. So in-circuit serial programming ICSP header located apparently appropriately to plug in into the existing shields. So if we have any SPI shield that is compatible with the Intel Galileo Gen 2 board, so this will be having a port to connect with the ICSP header. So what we can do, we can simply connect that shield with using the ICSP header. So these pins supports SPI communication using the SPI library. So if we want to interface any peripheral that is based on SPI, that can be communicated with the Galileo, can be connected with the Galileo using the ICSP header, which is a 6-pin header. So now is SD card data logging. Basically, generally on some of the board, SPI serial peripheral interface is also used to interface the SD card. But on Intel Galileo Gen 2 board, that is not required. But still we can interface a SD card and we can store the data on the SD card. So first question is, why we need SD card and why we need to store the data on the SD card? So we know SD card is a memory. So why we require memory? Whenever you want to store the data. For example, you want to store the temperature, humidity and light for a one particular region. It may be your classroom, it may be your drawing room, it may be your bedroom and wherever. So you want to maintain the, let's say, we can say for automatic climate control, you need this data. All right. So you install a device which is having a sensor to detect the intensity of light, to detect the temperature, to detect the moisture. And you want to make the analysis. Let's say throughout a week, what was, we can say, the graph of variations in temperature, humidity and the intensity of light. So obviously, we need to read the data. We may read this data maybe in 1 hour interval or 2 hour interval, or it depends. So, and we need to store the data permanently so that later on we can transfer the data and we can make the analysis and we can find the peaks or downs like this. So data read from sensors can be stored on memory card and can be used later for the analysis purpose. The sensor data will be stored permanently in Excel, doc format or text format, whatever. Now state data, that stored data can be transferred and can be plotted. So that data we can transfer from the SPI or that from SD card, and we can make analysis using Excel and some other tools available for the data analysis. So this is the basically program for logging the data on the SD card. So in this program, what we have to do, we have to include the SD library to use the SD card related functions, to open the SD card, to close the SD card, to create a file in the SD card. All right. So the serial.begin is basically setting the baud rate to communicate with the serial monitor. Then serial, this is the initializing the SD card, whether we want to see whether SD card is available or not. The second is loop. What we are doing? First, we are setting the time. So what we want? We want to store the value of temperature, that is using temperature sensor, value of humidity and value of light with respect to the time. So what we have to do, we need to set the time first. So if you are using a RTC real time clock and you have interfaced a battery with that, so obviously that RTC will keep on running all the time if you remove the power of the board also. But if it is not like that, obviously we need to set the time for once. So these two commands we can see over here, These two commands are for setting the time of the system or activating the RTC, real time clock. All right, setting the time of that. Then what we need to do? Obviously, we need to get the temperature value. Using the sensor, we need to read the temperature value, means all the values, whatever you want to read, storing that value into the string. Here, getting the time first. So here we are reading the value of the sensors. Here what we are doing? We are fetching the time, real time, using from the RTC. And here what we are doing? Here we are adding the time into the string and adding the value of the measurements. So measurements are temperature, light and humidity. And then what we are doing? We are creating a file over here. So basically sd.open is a API which takes two arguments. One is the name of the file and second is the in which mode you want to open the file. So if that file is not available, for example, you have taken datalog.csv. If this file is not available, what this will do, it will find in the SD card. If file is available, it will open, and in which mode, read mode or write mode, that depends upon this. If you select file underscore read, then it will read only. If you file underscore write, then you can read also, obviously you can write also. And here what we are doing, we are declaring a variable, name is data file and type of the variable is file type. Then we are storing this value on the SD card, and then after that what we are doing, we are closing the file, and we can print also on the serial monitor. So this is where we are printing this data, the data string over here on the serial monitor. So this is the program which read the value of three sensors with respect to time and store with the time in one of the file. So you can create a .csv Excel file, you can create a Word file, you can create a text file. So in that file, with respect to the temperature, yeah, we can store the value of temperature, light, humidity with respect to the time. And later on, like I have used this one, so this example I have prepared, I have created a CSV file named as data log, and now I can transfer this file. So this is an Excel file, I can open it, and using this Excel tools, I can plot this. So this type of analysis you can make. So these all are the values with respect to, here we can see the time, here we can see the temperature value, here we can see the light value, here we can see the humidity value. And this data can be used for the analysis purpose. And that is basically very important. So that was these are the resources you can refer for further study. And please contact Foundation for Innovation and Collaborative Education, info@fice.in, mentor@fice.in. Thank you.